I have two refrigerators with the same problem, but the solution I found for both of them is different. The one refrigerator is this one, and the other I fixed in the customer's home. I am passing electricity through the refrigerator and checking the first refrigerator as I have passed electricity to the refrigerator. The compressor has started and consumes 6.4 amperes. And I am checking now for how much time the compressor runs. And see, it has stopped after 15 seconds. Now it will try to start once again. Again the compressor started and consuming the same current as it did before. Now I am showing the second refrigerator's compressor. As I passed electricity through it. This compressor is consuming more amperes than the first refrigerator's compressor. Now let's see what is the fault difference in both the refrigerators and their solution. Now let's talk about this first refrigerator. If you are experienced, you started the compressor and when it stops 2 to 3 times, you will know why is it consuming more amperes than usual. But if you are nor experienced, then I will tell you what is the issue that why compressor consumes more amperes. This is a Danfoss compressor. I am removing the relay of the compressor. PTC relay is used in this compressor. I will check this first that does it has any issue or not. I will check the compressor winding. First of all, I am connecting the probe with the common point of the compressor terminal and the second probe with the starting terminal. These points are showing 17 ohms reading on the multimeter. Now I will attach the red probe with the running terminal. These terminals are showing 15.2 ohms reading. Now I will attach the probes with the starting and running terminal of the compressor. We should get the sum of the previous values. 17 plus 15 is equal to 32. But the multimeter is showing us 29 ohms. Which is lower than the calculated value. So I am not sure whether the compressor is good or bad. To confirm it, I will perform one another test. Now I will test the PTC relay. The relay usually heats up and breaks. So first I will check it through the hands. I will hold this terminal and shake it. If you still hear a sound from inside the PTC relay, then it means the PTC sensor is bad. But if you heard no sound from the inside the relay, then test it through the multimeter. Check the running and starting point of the relay. I will check the resistance value of the PTC relay. The multimeter is showing 36.1 ohm reading of the PTC relay. This value is correct. Now I am installing another relay to check the compressor directly by removing the internal wires of the fridge. Now I have set it up and I will pass electricity. It is consuming the same amperes as it was before. Now it means that the compressor is bad and finished. Now the need is to install a new compressor in the refrigerator. Now let's talk about the second refrigerator. When the customer complained that the refrigerator is not cooling at all and other than this when we pass electricity through it. The compressor starts and takes high amperes. We thought that the compressor in this refrigerator is also bad. When we pass electricity through it again. Then the compressor started to run properly. And the compressor was consuming only 1 amperes. Then what happened when the third time we removed and installed the electricity, it again started to consume high amperes. Then I was confirmed that the compressor is fine. Let me tell you what the problem was in this refrigerator. An overload is used in this type of compressor. The overload is installed beneath the relay. This relay has 3 points, but the relay installed in that compressor had only 2 points, which I was unable to film. I don't have that type of relay now, only to make you understand I am using this relay. The relay in that compressor was not working fine. Its magnet was working absolutely fine. These 2 points were joined in that relay, and these points are joined in this relay. Through which the compressor starts. This wire had a loose connection, due to which the compressor started sometimes and sometimes not. After tightening the wires, the problem was finished. And this is how refrigerators had the same problem with different repair solutions. This much is for this video. I will see you in the next video. Click on the left or right thumbnail on the screen to watch our next videos. And subscribe. It's free. Thank you.